interesting, effortlessly brilliant, according to Telegraph. So, this Range Rover is designed to resist attacks by sarin, mustard gas, roadside improvised explosive devices, and bazookas. The only question in my mind, as I sighted that sucker in my Oxfordshire yard, was whether the hype was true. I was a journalist. I was a fully fledged car correspondent and expert. I couldn't just shallow this stuff from Range Rover, so all day long I had been brooding about a proper test. There was no doubt that the car was big and forbidding. That morning we were trying to take some photos on my Islington Street when a woman called Meg shot out of her house. "Shame on you!" she cried. "How can you drive that thing?" And it was no use the guy from Range Rover trying to explain that the point of the car was to save the lives of American presidents and Russian oil kings. "Oh, fuck that," exclaimed Meg. And she started to scoop up organic sludge from the gutter for use in her compost. "Take it away. It makes me feel nauseous." I think it's nauseated, but anyway. So we took it away, and as I drove one of the children to school, we had great fun with the public address system. This car is designed against all sorts of worst-case scenarios, and if you want to negotiate with a bunch of Kalashnikov-toting militaymen at a roadblock without opening the doors, you just use a loudspeaker. So whenever we saw a bunch of kids at the bus stop, we would hail them, making sure to use our best Robocop accents. According to the hype, it is the ideal vehicle for every political target from George Bush to the most gaff brown Tony Shadow higher education spokesman. "You there," we would say. "Yes, you," we would continue as the poor kids flinched and stared around. "Be good today, work hard and achieve more." Then we would trundle on to the next bunch of surly looking kids. "Don't steal," we would say, and they would look up and see this terrifying tinted windowed vision of armor clad authority. Posh. That is the image. That is Range Rover sales pitch. But is it really justified? And as my finger curled now around the trigger, I had a sudden moment of panic. In my hand was a lethal weapon of a 177 air rifle. Is he allowed to do that or speak like that? At least it was pretty lethal if you were an apple. Only a few minutes ago, I had fired at a large Granny Smith, and the results were very nasty. Poor Apple. And poor me, reading this. There was a huge exit wound, and for the final second before I fired at the car, I had a terrible notion that the whole thing was a con. The glass would shatter, the alarm would go off, I would get a furious letter from the managing director of Range Rover, copied to the editor of GQ. In fact, it must have been on that thought that I finally squeezed the trigger. The air rifle coughed in the gloom. The slug flattened itself on the darkened glass, and not a scratch. "You win, Range Rover," I thought. I was going to fire again at the paintwork, but then I thought that would be unfair. On the other hand, if I ever get another, I'm going to hire a bazooka. Let Meg have a go. Good call.